Did you know that there's a private tour of Disney's Animal Kingdom? It's a look at the African wildlife in a way that only the trainers are used to seeing the animals. But first, you have to get off the beaten path.
Jammu, everyone, welcome up to our Outfitters Post.
It's like a jungle in here.
It is a jungle.
The Wild Africa adventure begins just out of sight of the tourist.
Whenever you come back into this particular area and you look at all the forests around you, especially all of this bamboo and how thick it is, a lot of people can't even tell that this entire area is back here.
First stop, getting fitted for the adventure. After getting suited up, it's the only contact you'll have with the wild world of tourists.
We do have to go through the village itself, so we'll be going past a lot of the different
tourists.
Yes,
and
even worse, there's strollers.
But from here on,
we are heading into the depths of the Aturi Forest.
It's off the concrete and into the woods.
We're going to get off of the beaten trail, and we're going to immerse you guys into the woods. This is where we take a turn for the wild.
And you never know what you'll find.
This is exactly what you would find in the forests of Africa. Animals could be around us at any time. We want to make sure we come through here fairly quietly so that we don't scare the animals, and we want to see them before they see us.
The first surprise, Hans and Henry, in a way that few people get to see.
A hippo is going to eat approximately 100 pounds of food every day. They basically eat all day long, so so I guess we feed them, 24 hours a day they wind up having access to food.
The males hang out down here, while the lady hippos chill out upstream in the shallow waters.
When a baby hippo is born, they weigh approximately 85 pounds, and they need the buoyancy of the water to help them stand up and to help them, you know, lift their head above water because they don't really have a lot of strength in their legs yet.
The babies are so big that there are no natural predators after they turn 1 year old. The only fear here is from the humans crossing these bridges over the giant crocs.
I'm gonna be okay.
She's gonna be just fine.
Once over the crocodiles, you're ready for the next step. One big difference here from a typical tour is that we get to stop, pull out the binoculars, and gaze at the amazing animals. Like gazelles, giraffes, and elephants, yeah, even a baby.
You look at the view all around you, and you are just immersed in it. It's amazing.
And one other nice perk with this tour, dinner on the savanna with one heck of a view.
We have two tiers of deliciousness in here. Let's take the lid off here. Now, if you look around the outside here, all of this cuisine in here is African-inspired and very, very delicious.
And we're talking an amazing meal with some pretty unusual foods.
Now, what about that flower on top?
That is actually an edible dendrobium orchid.
You can eat that?
You can eat that. It can be very sweet.
It's not going to kill me, right?
It's not going to kill you, no. May taste a little like celery. Could be sweet.
Better than celery. I hate celery. That's pretty good.
Then back on the trail and a few more beasts of the field, like rhinos and, if you're lucky, lions and tigers playing in the sun. It's an amazing adventure that you have to experience for yourself.
Harini, wonderful day. Absolute pleasure.
Harini, very nice to meet you guys.
Harini.